You've got something really notable to be sharing at the Google Health event, and it's an AI co-scientist. Just what will this look like? What will this feel like if you're wanting to do research?
Yes, Caroline, absolutely. The idea is we've built a system that works together with scientists. So, for instance, if it's a Friday afternoon, I'm in my lab, I have all these ideas I want to explore, but I have my two kids at home. And so I can actually plug in a research goal into the system, check the ideas it's creating and the evolution over time, and by Monday morning, I have a bunch of different approaches I can use for my research.
Technically, how is that happening? What is occurring over that weekend when you're able to go and sit with the kids that allows them to debate and draw out ultimately scientific findings?
Right, so it's a multi-agent model. So we have one that generates different ideas and kind of like a child where you have open-ended possibility to create all these different things, right? And then over time and experience, and we use databases and tools to refine, and then we use competition to improve things, and we rank and re-rank things over time. And it's through that evolution we create many different ideas that I could potentially pursue in my research.
Already, you started to show how suggested hypotheses are bearing fruit for certain organizations. Talk us through how, for example, Imperial College is already using it.
Right, it's one of my favorite examples. So we actually tried to look into antimicrobial research, and our system actually points us to papers where we can contact researchers and ask to say, you know, is this a good idea? And so we did that actually with Jose and Tiago. And as we reached out to them, they were actually looking at the same problem in parallel. And so something that took us 2 days to compute, they had been studying for many years. And the two systems in parallel came to the same result.
Ultimately, there's been much said, Annalisa, about how generative AI can bring fruits to bear when it comes to healthcare, when it comes to research, when it comes to tackling disease. Is this the reality that you're currently thinking can be the help with a co-scientist, an AI co-scientist?
We're at the early stages of the project. So in our paper, we show these three examples where we've seen that there is evidence in this direction, and we're looking forward to leaning in more and showing more capabilities as we extend this work.
Has there been any friction, or should I say just reticence, by the scientific community to allow models to duke it out on their areas of focus over a weekend while they sort of down tools?
There can be skepticism, but as a scientist, skepticism is good, right? It encourages that we push ourselves, that we create a system that's useful and something that's impactful for the community.
How have you stress tested it? For many, the limitations of generative AI and for agents is, well, the fact that they do sometimes get things wrong. When have you seen that occur, and how have you managed to counterbalance it?
Right, so no large language model is perfect, but we try to supplement this with novelty and checkness reviews. We both use the literature that's available and web search. We add in tools and databases, and we're learning to extend our work into knowledge graphs and other strategies where we can improve and refine on our techniques. The other thing is we're looking to the community for feedback. So we created a trusted tester program, and we welcome and open those different ideas and approaches so how we can improve AI co-scientist.
What's the demand been like?
It's been incredible. It's been an honor to work on something that other people would like to use. So we've seen thousands of different requests to get access to the system through our trusted tester program, and we're looking to make that available at no cost for other scientists in many different domains to try us out.
Ultimately, is it quite expensive, what you're offering? I mean, the compute power we talk a lot about across the show. So when a scientist has got the power to have a co-scientist sat alongside them, will it ever be charged for? What does the future look like?
As a scientist, I get to focus on the science side of things. And so really, when I think of research, I think of scientists' time, the ability to do reflection, and interaction are the most important resources. And we're trying to optimize those for scientists.
Is there measurability of productivity gains here? How are you thinking about success and what does it look like in terms of having this coexistence next to you?
So you brought up the Imperial College London case where we looked at antimicrobial resistance. And in our ability to compute over 2 days was something they had been studying for many, many years. And so this is not a replacement of a scientist, it's something to be used in conjunction with science, but the ability to get there and get there faster, we think will help make more breakthroughs.
How excited is Google about it?
I'm very excited. I think they're very excited, and we're hoping to get more feedback from the community tomorrow at the checkup event.